A very good day to your friends. This audio is brought to you with the courtesy of Jnana Dasana Association of Sri Lanka. May the Triple Gem bless you. In this audio, we discuss the topic of arousing metta in ourselves. To develop metta or loving kindness, we have to arouse it in our minds. Those who are interested in developing metta or loving kindness in themselves should first understand the importance of arousing metta in themselves. Without arousing metta, one cannot develop metta. We arouse metta whenever when we think of the virtues of our close associates. For example, when we have some kind of misunderstanding with somebody, maybe with the immediate family member, we can always try to think of his or her virtues. He or herself being compassionate at times towards yourself or ourselves. His understanding or her understanding's personality, these are things, helpfulness. These are things we can always recall. And when we recall these things, whatever ill will that has been gradually building in our minds would disappear. Always try to think of the good qualities of person. How helpful this person has been to you. And whatever ill will that is being gradually developed in your mind would disappear. So we use the same method to arouse metta in ourselves. There are two methods mentioned in the Dhamma. One is thinking of the virtues of the object. The object of meditation, here a lovable person in the case of a beginner to metta bhavana. You think how compassionate this person has been to you, how understanding he or she has been during the association, how helpful he or she has been to your life. So more thoughts of this kind you have in your mind about this particular person, it would be easier for you to develop metta or arouse metta in your mind. You will feel when you recall these things, whenever you think of these things, you will see this effect on your mind. You will see the gradual disappearance of whatever ill will that has been gradually building in your mind disappear. So you use this method to arouse metta in your mind. You can also recall events. So this lovable person has had a long association with you, so you too have had lot of contacts, lot of working together, etc. So you would remember certain things that are connected to you through this association. For example, receiving or giving of gifts at events, perhaps on your birthday or some other, at your wedding or some other occasion, helping hand given at times of stress, perhaps you were monetarily rewarded when you needed money, when you had a difficult situation, and you can recall these things. Or whatever good advice that was given to you when you needed that advice badly. So you can think of these things and metta would rise in your mind. You must make sure that you do not remember or recall unpleasant things, unpleasantness, whatever unpleasantness that occurred between you two. And you must not think of these things. If you think of these things, ill will would arise instead of loving kindness. So after having aroused metta, you can use the aspirations, four aspirations, and they should be repeated in your mind very softly. May he or she be free of enmity. May he or she be free of mental suffering. May he or she be free from physical suffering. May he or she takes care of him or herself happily. These are the four aspirations that you must use to develop whatever initial metta that has been aroused in your mind. And when metta dies down from one aspiration, from one quality, for example, you recall an event of receiving gifts or being compassionate, and you develop loving kindness along this quality. And when metta dies down, gradually it will die down, you may use another virtue to continue your meditation. So once you practice this, it would be easier. It would become easier for you to develop metta to this particular person. So thank you very much for listening, friends. May the Triple Gem bless you. This audio was brought to you with the courtesy of Jnana Darsana Association of Sri Lanka. A good day to you all.